There was a scene in a recent One Piece episode that I can't, for the life of me, I can't fucking find the scene in the recent episodes I saw on Twitter Bar. But there's this moment, basically, where Chopper is in his deer form and he's running, and he's fighting against these zombies, and they're not, like, it sort of has that same, like, movements that you see in the Berserk episode, but, yeah, I can't fucking find it anywhere.
Okay, we can find it later.
Caesar.
I can find it later. I will put it on a video just right there. Just say, but two hero, my hero.
I don't know. It's somewhere between 363 and somewhere in the 350s. Between that. So that's like 13 episodes I need to look for.
Damn.
I'm browsing.
Now we got the mission.
I'm through 5 already. I'm thinking, like, well, what the hell was it? I saw it recently. What the hell?
Did you type in the tag names like Chopper versus Zombies?
No, it's not like. It's not like a full fight. It's like one of those scenes where they're fighting for a little bit and they cut away to someone else's scene. That type of moment. So, like, it's between. Who's the strongest? Somewhere between 355 and 363. That's all I know.
Damn.
355, 356. Okay.
No, 363.
Okay.
Yeah, something there. I saw it earlier. I know I either saw it yesterday or the day before, so I don't know where the fuck is it. We'll just keep talking. Hopefully, I'll find it.
Just to sum that the Berserk complaint, I'll tell you one thing though. Far as I know, that the show is bad. I'm still watchable. No, I think the video game's going to give it justice either way, because they said they're covering the entire Golden Age arc through the Black Swordsman arc, and I think towards the arc where he gets the Berserker armor. Mm-hmm. So kind of like what the PS2 did. So that's going to be great.
Yeah.
So that makes everything better.
Hey, you know what could be worst?
What?
They could have remake the entire Golden Arc again.
Fuck that.
Golden Age time. The arc that no
fourth
one
time.
Gets tired of.
It's
like. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Guess can't get tricked.
So we'll get 31 flavors of Golden Age and we'll never get to the right the Black Swordsman arc or the boat. I mean, I wouldn't mind watching a whole season of the boat.
It's not even what they call it. It's not called Berserk anymore, it's just called the boat.
I'm on a boat.
I can narrow the results a bit. Now it's for sure like somewhere after 356. That's all I know. Somewhere after that and before 363.
Oh really?
Yeah, because that's where they're really starting fighting. So I'm thinking, okay, so it has to be somewhere between 357 and 363. Somewhere in the middle of that is what I'm looking for.
Damn, dude. You gotta start highlighting this stuff, man.
Well, that's the problem with One Piece. I literally have to write down notes, otherwise I'm not gonna remember what footage is where.
Yeah, man, it's like, how many episodes do they have at the moment?
I think 700, actually, so.
Oh, shit.
Fuck.
Yeah.
700, oh my god.
That's my life right there.
That's my life.
That's
We're
that's
on the
like,
boat, that's my life. 7 years equals 700 episodes.
I don't know. I'm just trying to find something, but I'm having like little luck with it.
Yeah. Let me ask you something real quick.
Uh-huh.
How would you, if we ever had a Fist of the North Star remake?
Mm-hmm.
Imagine it with this.
Yeah,
studio.
I know what you're gonna ask. Like, I can already tell where this is going. So.
But imagine if it was like the Pachinko CG. That'd be nice.
No.
That wouldn't be a problem right there. That would look good because it has those visuals, but.
But I.
Hmm?
I think those would make pachinko machines are more businessmen than anime nerds and.
I guess.
Anime business.
I don't know what the hell's up with. Nobody knows what the hell's up with pachinkos and the things they do.
My heart
know,
sore.
Like,
my heart sore when Metal Gear Solid 3 came out on pachinko.
We got the new moon approved to show Fist of the North Star and Berserk, man. Only on pachinko. A or give you half the shit on TV, which looks really bad. That's okay. It's still cool. Give us your money.
All of it. Give us your money. All of it.
Taff, you would be pissed off if they gave this to freaking Ashita no Joe. You know that.
I'm already pissed off. They only did Ashita no Joe on Pachinko.
I know, but I'm saying, like, imagine they just...
he means with, like, the 40 received animation. That's what he means.
Yeah.
But I don't know. I'm thinking, like, what is he... Would it be that much of an insult compared to the 70s animation? Like, I mean...
Dude, Rosa Versailles looked amazing in 70s animation. Like, even at that time, it looked good.
Well, it was 79 for Versailles, but Joe was, like, 70, 71.
Damn.
Yeah. But yeah, then... I should know, though, 2 come around 80s. 80,
like literally early. 80, 81, that was part 2 of Joe. So. But from 2 to 1, that's like a vast, vast difference of qualities. I'm just like, shit.
Yeah.
I don't know why, but I feel like sharing a clip. I feel like sharing something. Like, I haven't found the episode I was looking for yet, but I'm getting closer, right? I feel it in my gut. But, yeah, well, actually, can you hear the audio to begin with? Let me hear this.
Alright. You can share screen it?
Yeah, well, that's what I'm doing right now.
Alright.
Hold on, let me take a few steps back, because I don't even know that.
Alright, full screen. I'm greeted with a smile.
Maybe you can hear it. You don't hear anything, right?
Yeah,
I can see. Oh, this episode.
Can you hear or not?
I cannot hear.
Hold up, then. I gotta do is stop sharing, unplug the speaker.
Oh no!
Plug it
He's
back
gonna
in.
Unplug it.
Yeah.
Unplug it in.
Yeah. Although, let's see what happens now.
Quick, is this Japanese or English?
English.
So, same smirk at me.
Are you able to hear anything or no?
Not yet.
Oh, shit, what the hell?
I see a still picture.
Okay, I'm not sharing anything, but let me just, like, play the audio. Maybe if you hear that.
Can you send the link to us? I might see it if I can. I don't know, but I really feel like singing nowadays.
Are you gonna try to be a singer, Taff?
I'm gonna be a rhymer first.
A rhymer?
Yeah.
We're trying to be Busta Rhymes?
I think I got it now.
I'm sorry for this.
Alright. Okay, now there's a fucking lag. What the hell? Damn, I don't know what's with this shit.
Listen, I ask people, you know what, I ask people with animation, I always say...
I am blind.
Oh, I hear it.
I think this time it should work. Let me share screens now.
Alright, just scream.
Yeah, just
clear the entire...
Alright.
Yeah, I don't know, I just found the way this scene ended, like, to be fucking hilarious.
The way... I didn't expect you to have a... good blade, being that you're a samurai and all. That's settled. I'm gonna meet you and take that sword as my own.
Yeah, I don't know, I just found that hilarious.
I got something. I got the picture.
What you got?
I got picture.
Picture what?
I don't know. I just saw the last image. See. What did I search for? Pachinko.
Pachinko. No.
Pachinko, it's in my mind. Alright. 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 Okay, so I already cut out the. Just to let you know, I already cut out the part with when we were talking about the Berserk episode. So we now can just have a free for all.
Free for all? Alright.
Yeah? because the discussion of Berserk episode ended for like, what, around 20 minutes ago?
Mm-hmm.
20 minutes?
You know, Taff, I'm always going to ask people this question, man, when they see this episode. It's like, was it visually stunning? That'd be a tough question to answer, man.
It was at least interesting, can I say.
Interesting? All right, fair enough.
Visual interesting.
All right. Like, how interesting is my question? Least, you said least interesting?
Yeah, well, at least it's interesting when it comes to how in 1 week they could pull this off.
True. Yeah, I know, that's true, actually, in 1 week.
Because I'm very old-timer when it comes to animation. I mean, I'm very used to, like, watching the what? Like, 80s, 70s, 90s.
You can, like, the era before CG came to the screen. You know what, Tech? You can go back. You can go back at the time when Reboot was still around, the old CG animated show.
Oh, fuck me. Fuck me with Reboot.
Yeah, you remember Reboot?
Huh? Yeah, it's the lowest CG of all.
Lowest.
Reboot. Reboob.
That's what the show is called, though. Reboot, man. Oh, back on Tsunami days, man. It was good. It wasn't clunk. Yeah. You want to talk about old school? I can go old school. Look at
what
that.
Was this, this was like in early 2000, right?
I think it was 90s.
Okay. I don't have. I don't know.
90s. See. 90s.
Yeah. No, early. 80s,
it was 90s, and I think somewhere like later in 2000s, but. You know, this is, keep in mind, this is the days when Tony J was still alive doing the voice for Megabyte. You know what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Like, he died like somewhere in like kind 2006. Long ass time.
Yeah, because I remember even back in the 80s, you know, it was in the music videos like CG or something.
Hold on.
It looks very clunky.
Wait, what did you say, Hero? I didn't catch what you said.
1994 to 2001.
Yep, that's it.
Apparently, there was a sequel series called Reboot. The Guardian Cold is in production as of 2015.
Ooh.
Oh, there's something.
Okay, that's quite a change, if I have to say it myself. I mean. From, like, this goofy, friendly look to this.
Whoa. That does look different. What in the world? I'll be keeping relevant to the past, the old concept. Nothing like, I want to be goofy, and just, like, keep it relevant. Like Transformers.
I mean, it looks very abstract. Like,
yeah.
There's almost no face in it. Good God.
I know.
Oh, wait. Sorry, that wasn't the right picture. This is the right picture.
Let me take a look.
There we go. That's the Reboot we know.
There we go. Perfect. So maybe one of those are the droids. I like how this discussion went from Berserk CG to Reboot CG.
It's only natural to go for that.
Man. I mean... I would love to see Berserk, like, in that, like, I'm just saying, just, I hate to go on that topic, but it's like, I would love to see it like they did with that Final Fantasy Advent Children movie they did, man. Because the CG looked amazing in that. All the details and everything.
I'm just searching images so I don't have to implement it later.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, this one, yee-hoo. Look at the animation on this one. Look at all the hair you can see.
All the detail on the metal and shit. Yeah, look at them. If you watch the fight scenes in there, it's really good too, man. I mean, it's like, oh, man, I should be looking at Berserk and that, like that, if you're going to sit there and make CG. But, oh, you know, what's that movie called? Captain Harlock was in that too.
Yeah, of course, Captain Harlock. It was like,
yeah.
Captain Harlock movie. I remember that one.
Yeah, it was incredible, dude. It's like, holy shit.
Now, how about them details, huh?
Mm-hmm. It's like, I don't know. What do you have to say about that, Hero?
Well, Well, I don't know.
Arrow.
Like I said, like the whole CG argument is like, I really don't give a fuck because.
Because you ain't seen
anything to change it. Like, we can complain all I want, but like, it's here, it's the way it is, then it's not like I can. It kind of reminds me back when Diamond Unbreakable got announced, when their people were literally making polls and arguments saying that it's not like the original art style, which,
yeah.
You know, that was just like a minor nitpick big time, really.
Yeah.
But then compared to this one, where it's a more legitimate complaint, I don't know what would, where could this lead? I mean, I don't think they will go back and, they'll probably go back and fix some things, but it will be nowhere near as what we wanted originally to be. Not to mention, I had this damn argument, like, literally, like, well, not an argument, but a discussion with a friend of mine again, like, three days ago, and I'm just getting kind of, like, really fed up, because I'm just saying things that really don't go anywhere, and then the same thing goes to, like, the fan base, the YouTube fan base, or just the Berserk group in particular. I don't know, we're just, like, pretty much arguing and complaining in circles with no progress whatsoever. Even then, like, the show already has, like, so much hate right off the bat, and it's understandable. And then there's others that obviously they'll defend it, or others are just in the middle, and, like, I don't care, I just kind of want to watch something.
Right.
It's got to the point where you're kind of hearing, like, everyone's opinions, and, like, me personally, I feel like whenever I hear so much, like, negativity or anything, really, whether it's negativity or praise, I start getting headaches. Mm-hmm. Like, that's literally how much, like, it bothers me, because, like, it's sort of like, I understand your complaints, I can relate, but you don't have to tell me, like, 24-7 all the time, and that's kind of, like, what's kind of annoying me more than anything. It's just people, like, shut up about it, because I'm thinking, like, I already know this, guys, I knew about this since day one when I saw the episode for myself. I don't need to hear your opinions anymore, like, I get it, I heard you once, I listened, like, I get you.
Now, well, I mean, just... No. Well, much. Well, it's not like
more productive,
well,
not, I guess.
Well, it's not like, you know, I'm sitting here buying it. I'm watching it for free on the internet. But at the same time, I'm spending my time, and, you know, I'm not getting paid to do this. I'm not getting a check after, you know, after releasing this. So it's like, you know, where's the effort? Where's the love for, you know, for the appreciation for your fans? That's all I'm upset about. You know.
That's true.
And I'm just gonna just throw shit in my face and just say, hey, you either love it or leave it. You know, like, what kind of appreciation is that?
Yeah,
now,
no,
I don't
complain
off the bat. Because I was defending this. I was no, let's just say it. Because, like, at first, dude, I was defending this at first. I was defending Berserk. I was defending the fact it was CG. I said, I don't even care if it's CG. I don't even care. So it looks good when I first saw it. But when I saw the first episode, I was like, man, did I look like a fool after witnessing it, you know? So I'm just amused. But it just depends on how well, you know, like, it depends how well they adapted. I mean, rather than, like you said, minor nitpick. Yeah, I can ignore all that. It's just that, oh, like, JoJo Part 4 looks good. I had no problem with the manliness. We talked about that before. I was like, well, it kind of evolutionized anyway from the books.
Yeah.
Remember
yeah,
that?
Because to be honest, I'm very tired of be talking about the CG, especially with Berserk, because I think I've been doing this now for 3 times, and I even once tried to plan out a video just to say it.
Dragon Ball Super all over again, where people are complaining that the animation isn't good, and now for Berserk, which is like a different art style also, like, no one's really liking this either.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know, people have been paying attention more to animation recently. Okay, I think I found what I was looking for. I'm hoping it is, because the animation looks a little different in this episode. And it's the 361, I think. I'm just waiting to see Chopper run.
Wait, who the fuck is calling me? Who the fuck is GRGR?
Interrupt the Berserk rant.
It wasn't more of a rant. It was more of a.
I don't know.
Conversation.
Yeah, because
I was saying.
Could I share screens or not? Or
wait, I think you can share screen.
Because I don't think audio is necessary for this. I think it's just mostly the sound.
Yeah, I think it's better because I don't then get like a copyright notification with the audio.
Yeah,
really?
Because the image isn't an entire full screen. There we go.
Yeah, okay.
Look
well,
at that
like,
pixelated
tell, like,
face.
You can tell already that by this point, the Nico Robbins and Nami started to have the hourglass figure, but that's not what I'm talking about. It's when it starts, you might see some lags at the moment, but I'm waiting for when Chopper starts running, because there's some moments where, in the style that he runs, because even you can tell by Robin's face that's a little, like, off-model or something.
Kind of waiting that for body, it. Though.
Yeah, the
body. That body, though, man. How about the top 10 asses?
It's like a little off.
Yeah.
Like, I know it's supposed to be somewhere in this scene where Chopper comes in running. Like, yeah, like even Dr. Hotback's chin. Like, his chin doesn't even look like this a chin. It's sort of like blending in with his neck.
Yeah, I know. It kind of does.
So that's one example like where he doesn't. Because he has like a very thick chin. And right here, it just sort of blends there.
Well, hi, Chopper.
Somewhere around here.
How are you doing?
Yeah, it happens here. Because Chopper, like, is going to start running in his deer form. And you see, these shapes. Oh, see, we're goes full circle of Berserk. We have dogs. We have a possible dog. And now we have zombie dogs.
Oh, we're going full circle?
Yeah, right here, look at this animation. So. Like, the way it bends and curves.
You don't have no to pay.
Yeah, the way the smoke is and everything, so it's kind of weird because it's like fluid movements, but the characters have like these awkward shapes and postures.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This, is this by Toei? Is Toei making this?
Yeah, well, I don't know. I mean, another example would be like that one Naruto Shippuden episode where they're fighting Hidan and Kakuzu, and it's like very misty, like very, like, here you go, there's the running scene I'm talking about.
I mean, the lag just makes it easier to see the problems.
Yeah, if you take like shots of like every frame, it is gonna have like a weird angle or thing. But yeah, it's 361, so yeah, that's what it was.
Thank you so much for that.
Yeah, it was around it's around the 10-minute mark. I just put that 10-minute. Yeah, that's one example. Like the other one I can think of, where it's not really that off model. It's I don't remember what number it was, but it's when the Shikamaru's team is fighting Hidan and Kakuzu with Kakashi. And it's like this very, like, the colors are like super faded and they're like very mist looking, but everyone moves like really smoothly though, and it's a really well choreographed fight. It's just that, like, why do we have to sacrifice our colors to make all this possible, basically.
I mean,
kind of crazy. And then if you watch the anime No Ween, like, there's some scenes in that show where it just looks like, whoa. The animation, like, it's in my review, I'll find that. The animation for Noween, it shifts so much. There was, like, three different art styles in that damn show.
Oh, man, that's good.
Oh, God, God damn, I mean.
Yeah, so you can, it's pretty easy to spot, also, like, it's super noticeable. Because I know for sure, it was supposed to be a production IG show, I think it was Satellite. Satellite was the main one, but then you see Production IG do like some episodes, and then you see like this other group do other episodes. I'm kind of wondering who did that. Was that Gainax or some other group?
Can you type the name in the chat so I can search for it?
In the chat.
It's no. Oh, I spelled that. No. Shit!
No shit!
Yeah, awesome, man. It's been lighting up, but that's how it's spelled.
All right.
No ween.
No
ain. But you know, I'll screen share once I find it, because that's the Satellite Company is a anime studio that usually blends CGI with animation, usually. So they're known for that.
All right, I just googled the name and I immediately found something different.
I found it.
I found it too.
I did? What did you find?
That was kind of weird.
All right, so I don't know if this is a no. Sorry, maybe this is not a. Okay, I don't know.
You said Noween. Is it like
Noween?
It's like kids in here, anime kids or something like that.
Yeah,
it's
mostly about the perspective of kids with these other people. Yeah, it's like a sci-fi drama. Well, it has to do a lot with the time travel and parallel universes, basically. So, yeah, okay, I found the clip on my review where it changes style.
Ooh.
Yeah, because it was kind of, yeah, let me screen share this. It's kind of weird because there are clear moments where the animation just dropped and other moments where it's good. So it's like a very consistent animation style. Like here, well, you can see my blank faces screen, can you? Or...
Yeah, I can see it.
Okay, perfect.
Yeah, that's blank faces, but then episode 1 and 2 is like such a big example where, yeah, okay, I'm right there doing the Gantz example. But yeah, take a look at these three faces.
Oh.
Vastly different. And then,
I mean,
like right now, I'm just, yeah, right here's a screenshot of episode 1 by the ending of it. We see the boy and the girl. Then episode 2, like, you're gonna see it just fade in. So look at that.
Oh.
Shit. Like, oh. Drastic.
What's this mean?
Okay, one thing. You have no excuse if you have, like, two different or three different animation styles. Unless they're actually taking from a different point of views. I mean, maybe cop scenes like this or some other people scenes like that. But yeah, if it's the same shot but same...
During a fight scene when they're fighting the air. And you just look how much it warps. Like, hold on, you'll see it. Like, it moves really smoothly, but at the same time, it looks kind of like if the character's gonna go off model or something. Right there, I was worried about the paint.
Horseman!
That's crazy.
Can I mount that horse? Man?
See what I mean?
Or maybe
like,
should
right,
just...
right there, there's some good CGI mixed in with the animation. It's like, it's just like a strange-looking show, really, where... It just fluctuates so fucking much with its art style. But yeah, like the horse thingy, that was from that, you know, infamous Naruto Shippuden episode where Naruto fights Pain and everyone was like mad as hell or wondering what the fuck's up with the art style.
Yeah. That one is a classic. I feel offended you saying it's bad. It's a classic episode.
That classic. Yeah, if you just put in Naruto vs. Pain animation, you'll come across a lot of it. Or you just watch the fight yourself, and it's just kind of ridiculous. So I don't know. Like, so when Berserk was doing the horse thing, I always get reminded of those moments because I don't know whether it's more of a subjective choice, whether it's that good or bad or what, or they're trying to do something but it just didn't come out right. Or fuck, I don't know.
Well, I mean,
I really don't know when it comes to that. Particular style, because then if you see shows like from that director, what the hell's that director's name?
What does he work on?
I forget his name, but he's the one that makes Ping Pong, Kaiba, the Love Type series.
Ping Pong, Kaiba, that sounds so damn familiar.
You know,
I still can't believe there's an anime called Ping Pong.
Well, let me look at his name. His director is, what's the director? Yusao Masaki. Cool? There we go. This guy.
Alright, are you sharing?
Yeah, I'll give the link. I'll give the link to, like, this guy's stuff.
Alright. Oh, he looks kind of handsome. I said kind of because it's not entirely.
Yeah, he's done a lot of directing, so when you see, you know what a show is by watching his thing. Like, let me get a Kaiba, my Kaiba review up. Kaiba.
He did Space Dandy too.
Space Dandy?
Yeah, second season.
Episode of the. It's the one about the fishes, where they are different.
Did not know that.
A lot of stuff under his belt, but like the series that are like truly his, like you'll recognize the art style immediately because you know how he wants stuff to look. Like I'm gonna screen share like the Kaiba discussion that I did with Random Anime. Tell me when you see bubbles.
Bubbles.
Hold on a second.
All right.
My bubbles.
Oh, there we go. You were sharing? Oh, that cool.
Yeah, I'll play it now. Yeah, you can tell because everyone has like these really curvy shapes. Well, in Kaiba specifically, this one has more of an Astro Boy art style, but you can tell when things look very like it could easily be mistaken for like a derpy looking animation. Because the way it's done, if I could just get a better example.
Are you sure? Are you sure? Because it kind of reminds me of Super Milk Chan.
Like, that's one
he's
example.
Very...
Yeah, hold on, let me find one weird. Here we go. Like, take one of the episodes, this scene right here, or after I skip the Galaxy Express picture. You should see them like in this party. Like, most of this animation looks like that, where it's like these weird looking shapes.
Bloop, bloop, bloop.
And like, of course, the frames can be like, there'll be some skip frames or just like weird looking movements. Eccentric, I guess. It's right there, like, it's, I guess, kind of normal, but then just the. It really varies. Like, once you see one of his shows, you'll recognize that, yeah, that's his thing. You can tell.
Like there's art style and stuff like that.
Yeah, his art style. Like, just, a lot of people basically like... don't like it because it looks like crap, so that's the thing.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh.
Well, like, a lot of people that don't like his stuff, so. Or you could just say that, it's very artsy, or I remember one quote from Pan Pizza said, like some people say, like, if there's an art style that you like, they will say, like, oh, it's an acquired taste. And in other words, that means, like, it looks like shit, but I like it.
Yeah, I mean, same thing, kind of like One Punch Man. It's like, but art style is shit, yet the story is so good.
Yeah, I think the art style is more simple than
it's very
shitty.
Simple, but
oh,
very,
but
very
this long link. Oh no, what have you done?
It's ping pong the animation. Look at it, bro. That's another thing that he directed. So.
Oh, that face.
What?
That face. It's a masterpiece, I can say. I mean.
Masterpiece?
Picasso.
Yeah, it's one of his shows that he intentionally makes things look like that.
Oh, Lord.
Like very surreal and abstract. But, yeah, but supposedly a lot of his stuff is, like, really well-written, and supposedly Ping Pong is, like, one of the best that he's done.
Yeah, man, like, if you have a very shitty art style, but it has something unique about it, that's the kind of things I like about it. And I do like this style.
I like this one.
This kind of takes me back to the days when they used to show, like, things like Paprika and like, those old 2000-type animation movies.
Yeah, I haven't watched Paprika yet.
And... You haven't seen Paprika yet, man?
Yeah. Yes. I mean, it's on my list, but I haven't seen it yet.
You need to watch it.
I feel so bad.
You know the Animatrix, the segment about the kid that just running around in school.
Yeah, I remember that.
Oh yeah,
that's another example, I guess, of the similar art style that we're sort of talking about, where we're like running around and it's like. Pretty crazy looking.
Huh? Yeah, because this guy's animation was also with Takeshi Koike, because both of their works were in there. Funny that you mentioned that.
Alright, time to screen share something. You are gonna be kind of happy.
Happy, sir.
Happy, yippee. Nice to meet you, P.
Kipiaye. Yippee-yay.
Okay.
Yeah,
Motherfuckers. Can't wait for that movie to come out.
Oh yeah, it was a. Oh shit. Can I fucking share screen this? There.
Is it working?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's view this beautiful scene. No sound though.
Oh, that.
I think we're gonna watch. I don't know, but it's right. It could be very skippy here.
I wonder how it looked like it's skippy with that skippy animation.
Right now it is like lagging on my end, so.
Yeah, it's lagging even to this computer, so I don't know.
Oh, no.
Oh, there you go. Nope.
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 Not having an animation.
I'm not a mirror. Oh, there you go. There it goes. A little more smoother this time.
Yeah, it really is.
Yeah!
It's like easy on my end.
Boops!
Bro, I look like Boops. He's about to go. Dude, he looks like he's about to eat the booty like groceries, man.
I never heard that.
Oh. There comes the...
It's a joke that came from Nash EXP.
wait. As sort of... Oh, there you go.
Yeah, look, right.
Actually, in later parts of the episode, I was actually kind of surprised on her waist more than anything. So I was just like, "Wow, that's a very smooth-looking waist that you got there."
Oh.
Whoa.
Shit, Japanese—they don't mess out on animating well-framed perverted scenes. It's like we won't animate anything that looks epic. We'll just animate titties flying around all day. It's easy money. It's the Japanese way. Don't say that's a lie, because it's fucking true. Yeah. I don't know, man. Who's that guy who's animating, what the hell's his name? Forget the dude what's it called? Boy and the Beast?
Oh. Yeah, I don't remember his name either, but...
Yeah.
Yeah, I know who you're talking about, so...
Yeah, because that dude... it's like and the next one, the guy. Oh. Yeah, Wolf Children. And... I've never seen Wolf Children, but I've seen Boy and the Beast.
Boy, okay. Finding a picture. Boy and the Beast.
Also, Takeshi Koike was involved with that, too.
Ooh-hoo. Oh, yeah. This looks like something I should have been watching already.
It's so good and manly. It is. You should watch it.
I'm not picking on the name, but what? Mahoro.
Guy. I'm not sure. Okay. Yeah.
This is offensive.
Yeah, this is director.
Just sounded racist.
Oh no. Hoshoda Soda.
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 Kind of soda. Funny. You soda!
Ah, soda.
You soda!
This guy got...
It's a whole soda.
Oh, he did. Yeah. Oh, I did Dragon Ball. Such a hole. Nice.
Ho soda.
Yeah.
Use soda.
What a ho.
Ho soda. Whoa.
Oh. Yo, you know Santa's like, you know, he's hanging up that shit. Like, ho ho ho. Ho everywhere. Oh. Have you been a naughty ho this year?
Oh, so you soda, be soda.
You've been a naughty ho or a nice ho?
I've just been shooting water.
I don't know whether you're naughty. Nice.
Let me get some rice.
Some rice. Coca-Cola. Hosoda.
Pepsi. What kind of nonsense are we talking about?
The guy's name. That's what it jumped to.
Sorry, Mamoru Hosoda. We picked on your name. Please don't sue us. I don't know, maybe that was one of those like million chances he watched the video and to this part and he's like, what the fuck, man? What the fuck?
What the fuck, man?
Like, he just doesn't even watch the beginning of the video, it just ends up going somehow straight into this portion where we're seeing it. I don't know. I don't know where else can we go because I think Berserk stopped a while ago.
Berserk, yeah.
Berserk.
Oh yeah, but I guess a little bit on JoJo is that, is it just me, or you guys saw the episode already, right?
No. Yeah, I saw the episode.
I'm like the only person who hasn't finished the season yet. I mean, I didn't even watch the season yet because I wanted to finish first.
Well, basically, I don't know.
All right, Timur can close your ears.
Wait, what did you say, Tim?
Close your ears. You can't hear this.
More detail on like JoJo.
Okay, talk about the JoJo.
Than what he was shown earlier in some episodes. So.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, he looks more masculine, if you know what I mean.
Who?
Those lines. All over his body.
Oh.
Oh!
The fucking curve someplace.
Neck muscles.
Edges, man.
Those diamond edges.
Yeah, he got a new outfit in this episode. A little more pointy, if you ask me. Okay. I can't hear you guys.
What'd you got?
Alright, let's go to the episode itself. Alright, we're skipping Berserk, we're just making this watch video. Because Jotaro, as I said, was very more like masculine, this video. I mean, I think is Josuke at some point, too.
It's like masculine and very fruity at the same time. I have to say fruity because all those colors, man.
Actually, Jotaro had a purple shirt now.
Does he have a purple shirt? No, that was in part 6, wasn't it?
Oh, who knows? Colors are not really canon in JoJo Universe.
yeah, indeed, indeed.
Not really canon. I mean, even if you were to take about colors, Jotaro's first color ever was in that commercial for, like, that old Super Nintendo game. I forgot what it's called. But
thing. I know. I can send a video.
Yay, he has blue. And now he has, like, a very dark green, I think.
Well, personally, I mean, I think the most common color for him is blue. Well, for part 3.
I think the common color for Jotaro is black.
Black? Like that black. Darkish, like that light.
I know they say black. I'm pretty sure it's like a very dark green because it doesn't look that compared to his hair.
No, it's black. Go away, hero.
I'm screen sharing the images of the recent episode. Yeah, because I guess part of it has to do with the wrinkles on his collar and shoulders, and the ornaments. But he just looks more masculine this time around for some reason.
More detail, man. Thank you.
Yeah, indeed.
I guess his dad, like whenever he wants to play. Right now he's just talking, but there's like other shots throughout the episode where he just looks like.
Wait, we pause at that scene when Josuke was having his mouth in the like,
Wait. Am I missing something? Am I missing? Oh, there we go.
Oh, there it is.
Yeah, well, you can just do another face and be like, oh, we're gonna be hunting down some chicks with nice bodies.
Yeah.
I'm a guy who's super love, so I never done that. I wonder if I could do it. Good.
I can't wait to she confessed us yesterday.
Yeah, like, that does look random. Purple and pink, man, so I'm just like.
He's a fucking pink.
I don't know, the discussion could be, yo, Josuke, you like my new digs? Yeah, nephew, it looks great on you.
Yes. Okay,
the white, the purple, and the black.
Okay, speaking of that episode, because I never noticed right was here, actually like, two rats.
Right here, the arms.
Oh, look at that. Look at that lines. Look at that lines.
The face. The face looks right
the
off.
Face, the face. That the outfit.
Jotaro, and I'm sexy as fuck.
It just won me. It's like... Hero, it's like... It's right when it starts getting to get more masculine, it drops down to part 5. Like, just kidding, bitch. We're actually making it more feminine than ever.
It's crazy if somehow the characters of part 5 look like more masculine in the anime. But there was a thing that I noticed in part 5's muscles that I didn't. I was gonna mention it in parts in the review for part 6. But I thought, like, you know what? I think I could actually talk about like. A video about different muscles, art styles, and in general. But what I was gonna say in part 5, this is what I noticed. So maybe I might be wrong about this. Is that I noticed that for some weird reason, they're all like they do have some muscle on them. You can tell by looking at their arms; they're just like very thin. But the strange part is that their torso is like really like big. They have like these large torsos, but they have like really small thin arms.
You showed me an example? I didn't notice that.
It's like a reverse Popeye, if you think about it.
Yes. Oh. Like those kind of cartoonish muscles, sort of like.
Yeah, because Popeye got big arms, but small body.
Frankie.
If you look at his front arms, they're like his front arms are really large, but his back arms are very small. But yeah, like. No, you have a good point on that. Yeah, I'm freaking.
How am I gonna get this tumor out of my arms? Some spinach.
Yeah, I mean, like, even Frankie from One Piece has the Popeye arms. Well, he used to do it for a while.
Very true. Very true.
Very true, man.
Popeye, man. Gotta give props to Popeye, man. King of manliness.
Yeah. Hmm. I don't remember what I was looking for. Oh, yeah. I was looking for that Jill. Yeah, hold on. Let me look for a mental.
Look for that torso, man. Look for that torso.
Yeah, because I saved a picture. It was one of Narancia. It just looked like really like buff looking, but his arms are like so, arms and legs are like really fucking thin. Just kind of
working. Really?
Yeah. It's like it's during the fight where he has that thing on his tongue.
Oh.
And yeah, it's a pose he does like right after he like has his tongue in his hand or something. He's just making this posture where you're just like, whoa, why is your chest so big? But everything else, not so much. I think I passed it. Yeah, I found
To be
it.
Honest, I thought Narancia was a girl first. That's 100% honest.
Yeah, because you can see like a big chest muscle and then the abs, but his arms are like much more thinner.
Oh, yeah.
Like that pose right there is just like. He's like really sticking out his chest right there, like, yeah, I'm a man today.
Yeah, you know, they always do that when they want to be like superior, like showing dominance, just showing your chest out like that.
Yeah, that's what they always say, but here, Narancia's just like, or Narancia, I think that's the right way to say it, but whatever. He just like, took one for the team. Yeah.
Hey. Yeah.
I don't look like a girl anymore. At least when I look manly.
Yeah. Mistake it for something else while I'm in prison.
I always thought the muscles to look kind of weird in part 5 because they're like, I don't know, I have a picture somewhere. Ah, fuck it. It's like, it's when Fugo takes off his shirt and his muscles have like these. Oh, I passed it. There we go.
Lost sound.
There we go.
Ooh.
Yeah, see what I mean? Like with Fugo. It's like they're like perfectly shaped. It's like there's no way you can have chest muscle like that perfect.
It looks like a doll.
Yeah, like it's like too perfect. Even with Kira, you can kind of see that it's like a little like that shape. But then if you compare that to part 3 muscles, with like their chest really sticks out. They have like a little like cave or something underneath it.
Yeah.
You know, they have like a thin. It's like their chest sticks out like 3 inches or something, like or 2 inches, probably like an inch or two, like off their body. You can see like this thick line under it. I was like, whoa, how big are those things? Like, I don't have the pictures, but if you look at like the beginning of Crusaders when Jotaro's fighting Hakyoin in the manga, like he almost looks like he's not wearing a shirt. Like that's how like thick his muscles are. Yeah, I'll probably look for that.
All right.
Sort of like what Jotaro was, looked like he was not wearing a shirt, but he really was. I don't know, maybe it's just the design, I guess, the way it's
sketched out. It just really looked like how big is your, like how thick are your muscles, man, that they could just peel through your shirt as if they were wet.
Ew. Ugh.
That'd be right back. I need to check the door.
Alright, yeah. But do you know who has the biggest muscle ever?
You know what? That's very debatable because I know.
It's fucking, you know, Broly because his shoulder muscles are bigger than his head.
Oh, really? Oh, yeah, it is. No, I was about to say if it was Juggernaut.
Juggernaut, but okay, Juggernaut. Okay, if Juggernaut, maybe.
Actually, is this only an anime topic of ant muscles? Because I know a perfect character who has overly used muscles.
Yeah, show me. Show what you got.
It's Megaton Man. Let me see if I can find him. That's a comic book character, but that motherfucker got muscles like it was like if Broly and Jurgen were like, God dang, this guy has way too much muscle. Yeah. Let me see if I can find him. I have a lag going on. Hold on. Yo, is that... What's his name from part 5?
Narancia. Narancia.
Why this motherfucker so pretty, man? Damn.
I mean, I really thought he was a girl.
Dude, same. And I was like, oh shit, it isn't. Like, even the voice sounded like a straight-up female, man. I'm like...
Awkward, can we, you could say.
Even Griff would be confused. Yeah. It's like, oh, chef, I took you for a female, my bad.
Oh, I'm sorry, I thought you was a female.
Yeah, really?
Can I have that back?
Oh, wow.
He's like very polite, but at the same time, very rude.
Very rude and like, you know, took it for an awkward moment. Oh my god, man, this is all bad. Just saying, don't be a pretty boy, man. I'm just saying, you be a pretty boy, and once again, you're gonna get the Puri Puri prisoner treatment. Watch out for that. Yeah, watch out for that motherfucker, man. Even Sonic would agree. I'm talking about Speed of Sonic. The monkey. Oh my god. Man, what's with this lag I'm getting here, man? There's so much lag going on. Oh, here we go. Hold on.
I don't know. I kind of feel also kind of lag because I got Project up, I got the recorder up, I even got Skype up, all running at the same time.
Man, Taff, you're raping my internet, man. Shit. Yo, dang PC. No, I'm joking. It's probably the same problem. I have like all the Skype going on, the internet's on. And I got Photoshop on too, so you know, everything's been. Let's see how much RAM I have left on here. You still there with me?
Yeah, I'll stay with you.
All right, just making sure. Got quiet. I have like 92% of RAM, so it shouldn't be lagging. I don't know why.
I don't know because sometimes internet can go very, very fine, and sometimes it doesn't.
Yeah.
You're just lucky. I mean, if you know exactly how much one side, how much it does take the processor, it could maybe be dependable if you could calculate how much. But right. Sometimes it's just random.
It randomly acts up, like, for no reason sometimes. It's like... I think it's just the software. Software's just, you know, eating it all up, the RAM and everything. I don't got this problem with. Hold on, let me. Sorry, you're about to say something?
No, not. I'm just. No.
All right.
Okay, I just found another piece of that smudging effect.
Smudging effect?
Yeah, I mean, I call it smudging because it's basically just dragging out the character.
Oh, okay. Here, look at this real quick. Here's making it to right. Man. That's an official art design of the character in the comic book franchise.
Okay. Alright, so should we make, I don't know, top 10 muscles in anything?
Anything.
Just have this.
And manga.
Let's just, I don't know, like. Make him the second place, then the first place we can have like every single character's muscle in it. Just to all make right. One person. Okay. I found a new JoJo stand or anything, what the fuck I mean, like. Have like a character just create a person throw his muscles. Like you're getting like very big muscle, like very over control, and then just pops out a person out of it.
I'd be like a new It'd be like a pillar man and a stand up the same mix. Cause you know they use their muscles to like, I don't know. You know what I'm talking about, right? Like the pillar men, they use their muscles for like absorbing abilities and shit. You know, they like using their, I don't know. It's,
yeah.
They can twist their bones and shit and everything. They use their muscles as their advantage. I don't know. It's weird. they're like
Taffy. Ooh, I see what you did there.
I didn't think about that at first until now. Oh my goodness. Yeah, man, the freaking, let's see, Savage Dragon. Look at Savage Dragon. It's pretty normal to me, but I guess not as crazy as Megaton, man. Look at this shit. Savage Dragon got over exaggerated muscles, too. Like, his fist is the muscles.
I see it now. It's very... Okay, though I take it back, his shoulders, well, the shoulder muscles are bigger than his head.
Kind of. Right? boy, Jesus, man. It's like, do you even lift?
I mean, just think about how much blood have to come through his arms. I mean,
yeah.
Doesn't he like faint? Does he have like double so much blood as a human?
He could probably got like 5 hearts in one. I don't know. It's like, goodness gracious, man. Like, can your body take the muscles? What about that die out there? I mean, you know, you want to talk about really detailed. I mean, talking about muscle designs, man. I think there's several artists that I know that have really, really, really detailed muscles. This is not even Japanese. So, what'd you find?
I don't know why. I just random searched when I found a name. But I found this one.
Oh.
What the?
Oh yeah. It's
okay. Don't mind. It's just what they're happening right now. Just look at his face. It's freaking.
Good lord.
Oh. All right. Let me just show it to Hero, so okay, just came back.
I see the picture.
Here go.
We're talking about.
Yeah, I already see them, but this is what I was looking for. And I took this panel of Crusaders for.
Oh, shit! I'm sorry.
And this
man. Freaking tap on this basement.
No, I was talking about like panels like these, where like Jotaro is wearing a shirt, but it doesn't look like it here.
Yeah, this one right here. This is the one I was thinking about. This is part 3, right?
Yeah, that's when he's flying that killing.
Can't see the
it looks like he's wearing a sports bra.
Yes!
His chest, like, really fucking stick out. Like, look at Star Platinum's chest, like, how much it sticks out.
You see?
Now you can see, like, there's a shadow underneath his muscles, man. That's how you know, like, that's how. That's what I'm kind of wondering. Do they stick out, like, 2-3 inches from your chest, or what?
Well, I mean. Be the same kind of question with this North Star, man. You see their muscles and they have no nipples.
Oh.
It's true.
Yeah, I mean.
Well, I mean,
oof.
You need to see.
What are you talking about there? You're talking about like muscle, nipples, horse, that's rapes.
Well,
no, I think, man.
This goddamn video is
like,
so
okay,
kinky.
Look, you see a female character design, you're sitting there, you draw a pair of boobies and shit, you don't know, you can't tell if she's shirtless or not, you gotta draw some nipples on that shit. So I can tell if you're wearing a shirt or not. Come on. I'm trying to put me in a box here.
So are we gonna turn now to like muscle girls or something?
No, man, I'm just talking about detail.
Okay.
I don't know.
God damn, guys.
Here's one.
Oh. Screw you guys. You're too kinky for me.
Sir, I see. Yeah, that's in coloring, man. That's in color, though.
Yeah,
I'm talking about it.
Actually, even Angel, like, in this picture, like, it's a small image, but... Yeah, like...
Why she look like a
female? Actually, because the way her boobs are in the chest area, you kind of just, like... I think we kind of messed up a little there.
I can't tell.
Really underneath, you see like a chest line underneath her collarbone. I'm thinking, like, I think the breast will need to be a little higher, guys.
It does. Yeah, no, I can see it. I can see it now. Because like,
it's
you first see it.
It's a pretty good image, too, but just like that area down there, like, I think we dirt here.
Alright. You guys are too kinky for me.
Leave me hanging with
I did not expect when
not
I did
I
this
going.
Video, except for reports.
I was going there.
Harold, don't encourage it.
I'm going to hang you like the hangman.
God dang it.
Yeah, I don't know, because I was looking at that Intercom picture and I'm thinking, like, wow, that's a really good picture. But then it's like if they were drawing the breasts at first and they didn't realize how much they had to draw afterwards or something. Like, oh, we just add another line there. This is actually one of the times where I say, like, usually you add a line, that'll make everything look better. But this time it's like, no, get rid of the lines.
Like,
she has too much of a gap between her collarbone and her breast. It's like, that's too much.
I don't want to over-exaggerate the line. All they need to do is draw a little line to tell
yeah,
you
yeah,
know.
Yeah, that or raise the shirt or jacket a little higher.
Yeah.
Yeah, one
that's,
of the
solutions.
kind of weird, really, looking at that now. Just thinking, oh, it's not
like
right.
Like a feminine version of violence. Yeah, for some reason, I don't know why, but it does.
I think you're thinking of that girl in the one in the other episode.
Are you talking about Jun?
The something writers, the
Elwin.
I don't know what they call it.
You want to see boops? Here, boops.
Hey, I can draw a good pair of boobs, man. I've done it myself. I draw some boobs because I need to draw detail.
I need a better boobs, sexy boobs. Design. Here, go.
Yeah, there you go. Where's the extra, extra large? Not fucking weird.
You're thinking of the one of Hell's Wind. There you go. That's
what I said. Hell's Wind, right?
It is like the same hairstyle, I'd say. But yeah, but then look at this guy, the Gogo 13 lookalike.
I'm having enough. Eyes. Right? I had enough. No more boobs. I had enough.
Hey, better than talking about this, man. I'm just saying. Yeah, what the hell? Yeah, what's up?
Yeah,
I had enough.
Because, I mean, like, we're called a manly podcast, but lately all that's been going on in the manly podcast because of JoJo things. So, yeah.
Well, I haven't got to the parts yet, so, I mean, I'm about to animate some scenes before we get back to the old JoJo topic we're on. Because I didn't get to the good parts yet.
Himoken?
Yes.
When you animate me split boobs.
Do you want a pair of boobs, Taff?
Just... I think this is a perfect note to end it all.
I'm playing.
Okay, I'm going to go out. You can continue discussing this, but I have to sleep.
Oh, alright.
Because tonight I'm going to dream about one thing. And I'm pretty damn sure that you already know what it is.
But... I'm a little lost.
Wait.
That would be extra, extra large. Go in a guy edition. Well, that looks good, man. I like that design.
Alright, nice boobs.
It's only in the cover. That's basically the only time you see that design anywhere.
Aw, damn it, really?
It's only cover art only.
Man, why does the cover art look so damn good?
Yeah, no, cover art's good, but that's about it.
Yeah, it looks so Americanized, I like that.
Well, it's still a good thing, the 80 Police is the 3 episode of it. It's still pretty cool, like, it's a sci-fi... It's a spin-off to Bubblegum Crisis, is the best way to put it. So.
Alright. I'm gonna end this video right now, and I'm very thankful that both Hero and Himoken can be in this. And I'm gonna just quit this video, I'm gonna save this video, and I'm gonna close this call, but you can recall again without me.
Alright.
Because I got a lot to do tomorrow, especially with the review.
And movies.
God damn it, Himoken. We are done. We are done professionally.
Oh, damn.
So, what are we talking about, vaginas now?
Camel toes?
Hero, you too.